నమస్కారం. డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ సార్వత్రిక విశ్వవిద్యాలయ విద్యార్థులకు స్వాగతం.
Hello friends, today we are going to discuss assessment of a partnership firm. Essentially, assessment of a partnership firm is almost the same as assessment of business income of any other entity such as individual or HUF. The points that are to be noted extra are two things. One is the treatment of interest on capital. The other one is remuneration payable to the partners. These are the two points which are to be highlighted in the computation of total income of a partnership firm. Interest on capital is an item which is deductible from the business income of the partnership firm. The limits that are stipulated under the Income Tax Act state that the interest is deductible up to a maximum of 12% per annum on simple interest basis, simple interest and not compounding interest. Any interest that is paid over and above 12% will be disallowed in the computation of business income. Such interest is to be calculated on the opening balance of capital of the partners. Suppose the firm has debited the P&L by calculating interest at 15%, then the 3% of interest that is paid over and above 12% will be disallowed. The point is to be observed. The other point in the computation of business income of a partnership firm is the remuneration payable to partners. Of course, why the remuneration is payable? It is a simple answer. The partners who invested their savings in the firm need some money for their domestic and household requirements. So, the remuneration is a legitimate amount payable by the firm to the partners, and even the Income Tax Act has acknowledged it and allowed it. This remuneration is payable according to limits specified in section 40 clause B. Further, it is to be observed that the remuneration is payable only to a working partner. From our previous knowledge of partnership, we know that partners may be active partners, dormant partners and so on. It is to be observed that the remuneration is payable only to active partners. Further, the remuneration can be paid only if it is stipulated and provided in the partnership deed in writing. And one more point to be observed is that remuneration cannot be paid pertaining to a period prior to the date of the partnership deed. Suppose the partnership deed is dated 1st of July, then the interest the remuneration to partners can be paid only from 1st July onwards. Now, the remuneration is based on a concept called book profits. Book profits are profits of the business after deducting all items which are laid down in the head of business, that is from section 28 to 44D. The definition of book profits is simple and clear. After deducting all items including interest on capital up to permissible limit of 12%, but before deducting remuneration. Of course, this is understandable. The very purpose of calculating book profit is to calculate remuneration based on book profit. So, it is logical that book profit is before deducting remuneration. Now, this is a very important point to be observed. In computing business income of firms, we should observe, especially in exam point of view, we should observe whether the given profits are after deducting remuneration or before deducting remuneration, after deducting interest or before deducting interest, we should observe. And in particular, the definition says book profits are profits after deducting all items including interest but not remuneration. Now, we come to the limits specified in section 40B. In case of losses, that is, if the firm incurred losses, remuneration that is payable to partners can be up to a maximum of 1,50,000. even if the firm has incurred loss, the firm can pay remuneration up to a maximum of 1,50,000 to all the partners put together. In case of profits, the computation is in this manner. On the first 3 lakhs, 90% of such book profits or 1,50,000, whichever is higher, we can also say in this manner, subject to a minimum of 1,50,000, 90% of book profits up to first 3 lakhs, subject to a minimum of 1.5 lakhs, and if the book profits exceed 3 lakhs, on the excess amount over and above 3 lakhs, 60% of the book profits will be paid to the partners as remuneration. Now, let us take few examples to understand this minute points of calculation. Before I proceed, let me remind that the computation of business income is, as we have understood and learnt in the heads of income, that is the heads of income being salary, house property, business and profession and so on. So, whatever we learnt in the head of business or profession, it is pretty much the same. In computing the business income of partnership firm, the additional points are now being discussed, namely interest on capital and remuneration. To understand this, let us take a few examples. Let us see the first example. Here there are two partners and the firm has incurred a loss of 50,000 after charging interest at 12%. So, the given figure of loss is book profit ready to use, because the interest has been charged and the remuneration is yet to be charged. Now, this is a case of loss. So, the section 40B limits specify that in case of loss, the maximum remuneration permissible is 1.5 lakhs to all partners put together. So, A and B put together, they can draw a remuneration up to a maximum of 1.5 lakhs. After debiting 1.5 lakh remuneration to the P&L, the total loss of the firm will be 2 lakhs and such loss can be set off against other heads of income if any, and if there is no possibility of set off, then the carry forward and set off rules will apply. Before we proceed, let us elaborate on this word remuneration a little bit. Remuneration may be by whatever name called. It may be called as salary or bonus or fees or commission or any other name. Essentially, the remuneration is paid to the partners out of the profits of the firm, that is to be observed. Let us now go to example number 2. Here is a partnership firm, again having two partners. This time there is a profit of 44,000 after deducting interest on capital rupees 30,000. Now, the point to be observed is this interest on capital debited to P&L has been calculated at 15%, but we know that the maximum interest allowed is 12%. So, there is an excess payment of 3%. So, it is a simple proportionate calculation. For 15%, 30,000, for 3%, how much? In that way we calculate. So, the calculation is in front of you. The profit reported after deducting interest, but before deducting remuneration is 44,000. The interest disallowed to the extent of 3% is 6,000. So, the total profit or book profit for the purpose of section 40B comes to rupees 50,000. Now, this is a case of profit, and the rule says 90% of 50,000, that is 45,000, or 1,50,000, whichever is higher, shall be payable as remuneration. Before we proceed, we observe that the profit of the firm, book profit of the firm is 50,000, which is below 3 lakhs. So, the rule says 90% of 50,000, that is 45,000, or 1.5 lakh, whichever is higher. And obviously, 1.5 lakh being the higher figure, the maximum remuneration permissible under section 40B in this case will be 1.5 lakh. After debiting P&L with 1.5 lakh, the profit of 50,000 turns into a loss of 1 lakh. And as we observed in the previous example, here too, this 1 lakh of loss can be set off against other heads. And if it is not possible in the current previous year, it can be carried forward and set off. Let us now elaborate these points with the help of yet another example, example 3. Here there are two partners C and D. The profit given is rupees 2 lakhs and this 2 lakhs is after deducting interest at 12%, which is the permissible limit, but before deducting remuneration. And we should observe that the given figure of 2 lakhs is exactly fitting the definition of book profits. So, we are now ready to calculate remuneration under section 40B limits. Now, this is a case of profit, but the profit is below 3 lakhs. So, here too the rule applies in this manner. 90% of 2 lakhs comes to 1,80,000. 1.5 lakh is the stipulated amount, whichever is higher. So, the higher of the two figures is 1,80,000. The maximum remuneration permissible to both partners put together is 1,80,000. So, out of 2 lakhs, if 1,80,000 is deducted as remuneration, the taxable profit of the business for the firm will be 20,000. And at this juncture, let us remind ourselves that the firms are taxable at a flat rate of 30%. So, whatever income is earned on this 20,000, subject to other computation issues which we have not gone into, that is deductions of chapter 60 and so on. Now, let us highlight the provisions of section 40B with an elaborate example, example 4. Here is a case of two partners. Of course, it is mentioned that they are chartered accountants and professionals. To remind ourselves, we know that the business or profession head applies to business income as well as professionals. So, here is a partnership firm of professionals and they share profits equally, and the profit for the current previous year is given as 2,50,000 after deducting a couple of items. What are these items? Interest at the rate of 18% and remuneration. Now, according to 40B regulations, the book profit is after deducting interest, but before deducting remuneration. Since the interest has been deducted, but at a rate of 18%, which is 6% in excess of the permissible 12%, the excess amount of 6% will be disallowed. So, the calculation is proportionate, and we have seen in example 2 itself. For 18%, Mr. E is getting 24,000, for 6%, it will be how much? That proportionate calculation will be disallowed. So, the computation is as you can follow it. The profit given is 2.5 lakhs. The disallowance of interest on capital to the tune of 6% will be 8,000 in case of E and 10,000 in case of F, that is proportionate disallowance. And observe that the entire remuneration is added back. This is obvious. The very purpose of calculating book profit is to see the eligibility of remuneration. So, in order to find out how much the partners are eligible to take as remuneration, the remuneration actually debited would be added back, then it will be calculated according to 40B limits, and then the appropriate amount will be deducted finally. So, we add back the entire remuneration firstly. So, the book profit figure comes to 6,88,000, and this is obviously more than 3 lakhs. So, the calculation is in the similar way. The first 3 lakhs 90%, 90% of 3 lakhs comes to 2,70,000 or 1,50,000, whichever is higher. So, out of these two, the higher figure is 2,70,000, and the amount exceeding 3 lakhs, that is 6,88,000 minus 3 lakhs, on that 60% will be payable. So, this comes to 2,32,800, and the total remuneration payable according to 40B calculations or limits comes to 5,02,800. And the amount of remuneration actually debited to P&L for E and F put together is only 4,20,000. So, this amount debited to P&L is within the limitations, which means the entire amount will be allowed as a deduction. So, the amount of remuneration debited to P&L will be allowed as deduction, and the taxable profit of the firm comes to 6,88,000 minus 4,20,000, that is 2,68,000, which will be taxed at 30% flat rate. So, here are some examples that we have gone through, which highlight the application of 40B with respect to firm. We will also have to focus on the assessment of the individual partners. After all, our basics of income tax remind us that individuals are taxable. A partnership firm is an entity subject to tax, a HUF, a company, and so on. So, here we should observe that the partnership firm is a taxable entity, as well as the individual partners are also taxable entities. Now, in the individual assessments of the partners, how these items are to be treated, that is the focus here. The basic rule of income tax is like this: any income should not be taxed twice, that is, double taxation should be avoided. A same item of income cannot be taxed twice. So, the rules regarding individual taxation of partners are in keeping with this rule. Whatever item was deducted in the computation of business income of the firm will be taxed in the hands of the partners. That is because when the item was allowed as deduction in the assessment of the firm did not pay tax on that particular item, which means it escaped tax in the hands of the firm. Therefore, the same item will become taxable in the hands of the partner. That is a simple rule. To understand this rule, let us take that example 4 data and continue with it. In example 4, we had already observed that the firm had paid interest at 18%, which is exceeding the 12% allowed by 40B. So, in firm computation, we had disallowed 6%, proportionate amount pertaining to 6% was disallowed. That means, firm paid tax on that disallowed amount. The allowed amount on that the firm did not pay tax, therefore, the partner has to pay tax on that. So, the interest proportionate to 12% will be taxed in the individual assessments of E and F. Further, we observed that in example 4, the entire remuneration debited to P&L was allowed as a deduction. So, firm did not pay tax on that amount debited to P&L as a remuneration. So, that amount of remuneration will be entirely taxed in the hands of the individual partners. And lastly, after calculating taxable income and deducting tax, the remaining profit that is distributed to individual partners is exempted in the hands of the partners. That is to say, the share of profit received by the partners from the firm is exempted from tax in the individual assessment of the partners. That is because the same rule applies: the tax was paid by the firm and post tax profit was distributed to partners. So, the partners need not pay tax on that again. And after discussing these rules, let us apply to this example 4 in the case of E. In the case of E, interest, total interest received by E was 24,000. Out of that, proportionate amount relating to 12% works out to 16,000. You can see the calculation as 24,000 into 16 into 6 by 18. Alternatively, it can be calculated in this manner: total interest of 24,000, out of that 8,000 was charged in firm hands. So, 24,000 minus 8,000, 16,000 will be taxed in the hands of the partner. In this way also it can be calculated. And the remuneration received by E, 180,000 in the name of salary will be taxed. Please observe the point that these items are taxed in the hands of the partner under the head business or profession, that is under section 28. It may be misled that simply because the item is called as salary, will it be taxed under the head salary? It is not so. One should observe that the amounts received by the partner from the firm by whatever name called are all taxable under the business head only, under section 28. In the case of F also, the calculation is similar. The total interest of 30,000 minus 10,000 which was disallowed in firm assessment, so 20,000 is taxable in F hands, plus the remuneration of commission received by F, total of 2,40,000 plus 20,000, that is 2,60,000 is taxable in the hands of F as a partner. Let us now observe some procedural issues. In order to claim 40B benefit, what should the partnership do, or what should the partners do? According to section 184, the partners must write down a partnership deed, that is, it should be written and not oral. It need not be a formal document of deed, it may be in the form of a letter or any other document or correspondence also, but nevertheless it should be written. Then the deed copy should be filed along with the first written of income of the partnership firm. Subsequently, if any change in the constitution of the firm occurs, that is, retirement, admission, or merely the profit sharing ratio being changed, again the partners must file the partners revised deed along with the return. The firm should not be subject to any violations stipulated under section 144 section of the Tax Act talks about best judgment assessment. So, the firm should not be subject to any such violations. Then let us observe the definition of a working partner. This term is nowhere defined in the Income Tax Act. Any partner who is engaged in the day to day activities of a firm or in the planning and policy making and decision making and implementation of such policies of the firm, they are all covered under the definition of working partner. The amount of time spent by the partner is not important, that the fact that he is working for the firm is enough. With effect from assessment year 2010 and 11, the rules, the whatever we have discussed just now, which are applicable to a partnership firm, have also become applicable to a limited liability partnership, LLP as it is popularly called. Now, let us take an overview of the topic. The computation of business income of a partnership firm essentially is like computation of business income of any other entity, such as an individual or a company or a HUF, by applying the sections 28 to 44D, that is items which are allowed as deductions, items which are not deductible, and so on. The business income is computed. Then a partnership firm may also have other sources of income, such as property income or interest on deposits with banks, of course, but not salary income, because partnership firm itself is an artificial entity which cannot work anywhere. So, the computation of total income will be in a similar way as any other entity. The only extra focus is on the computation of the business income of the partnership firm. The point to be observed that the house property income computation is the same as any other entity, other sources will be the same as any other entity. Once we calculate total income, then the gross total income is calculated, and the deductions of chapter 6A are like any other entity. So, the focus point is on business income. And while calculating business income, section 40B is the key to calculation. And 40B stipulates or talks about two things: the interest on capital, which is allowed at 12% per annum on simple interest basis on the opening balance of capital, and remuneration by whatever name called according to limits laid down in section 40 clause B. Thank you.
Maa karyakramalapai mee soochanalu salahalu telicheyandi. మీ సూచనలు సలహాలు తెలియజేయవలసిన మా చిరునామా డైరెక్టర్ ఆడియో విజువల్ ప్రొడక్షన్ అండ్ రీసెర్చ్ సెంటర్ డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ ఓపెన్ యూనివర్సిటీ ప్రొఫెసర్ జి రామరెడ్డి మార్క్ రోడ్ నంబర్ 46 జూబ్లీ హిల్స్ హైదరాబాద్ 500303